Welcome to Doc's Lab and our second Master Series. Welcome to Friday night's video in our second Master Series. I do believe this is the 98th video in our second Master Series, the 47th video in our basic processors, the 10th video in our sculpting processors, and this is the first video on noise. So really quickly in this video, we want to create a noise library to work with. Keep in mind as you become a better and better audio engineer that your noise library is likely to grow, just to be careful. And keep in mind that you work with noise is normally very delicate and light work. So just keep in mind that your basic library will probably get done what you need to do. And sometimes you might be doing some high and low pass filtering or notch filtering or stuff like that. But for the most part, this library will probably get done what you need done if you spend the time utilizing it well. So basically, that when you start getting a noise file or noise library together, that you want to get a good violet noise, a good blue noise, a good pink noise, a good white noise, a good gray noise, and a good brown noise. This basic library of noises is the basic and fundamental noises you should be concerned with. There are thousands of different variations of this, hundreds of thousands of different variations of this in different situations. You probably won't have to worry about getting that detailed. And as you get to be a really good master audio engineer and you start mixing and matching them to get a much better result, it will come with time as you improve that you really hear with your acute listening that, no, I really need to mix this white noise with a little bit of this brown noise. And yeah, just like that, that works with this sound just perfectly, because you've gotten to a point that you really are doing good work and you're really understanding the differences. But don't be in too much of a hurry about that. This library will probably get done what you want. So first of all, what we want is, like, let's say I've got this violet noise, and this is a pink noise on here, but I've taken this violet noise, I've brought it in here, I've made it a certain length, I've made sure it's running just about zero, I've cut it to that length, and then I've put auto fades on it, and then I've bounced it and named it and drug it in here. After I've went through it and looking for any anomalies, any issues with the noise file, clicks, plops, bleeps, anything like that, there is a series on my first master series about editing, so you can go through there and watch that, and you, in case you might have to do some editing on the file. So once I've done with that, I've got the noise file and I've drug it in here, and then I want to make one file that is equal loudness contour work. Now, why I say this is because most of these noises have their inherent characteristics, which makes them unique, not only their spectrum, but also their spectrum as far as how much they fill out the spectrum, you know, like the difference between noise and saturation, and also that where they're boosted and attenuated as far as, you know, the spectrum is concerned, are two different things inherent in the noise. So the first way we can deal with some issues on that is I've taken each one of these and I've made an equal loudness contour variation of that. The other way is to mix and match them. So we'll get into that down here, but you can mix and match different noises to fill out the spectrum a little bit different, to smooth things up, rough things up, and things like that. But the first way is with equal loudness contour. So I've taken all those files, I've gone through with my settings we talked about, and I've got it set at equal loudness contour at 40%, like we talked about on the equalization segment of this second master series. And then I've rendered that file with 40% on there, which is going to boost it and attenuate in areas that the equal loudness contour dictates. That's going to change the sound of the file a little bit. That makes it sound more natural. Does that make sense? But not too much. that way that sometimes I really want, I think I need a violet noise, but it's a little bit too harsh. So the one with the equal loudness contour is more than likely going to sound a little bit different. Does that fit it? Or do I need to do the blue noise? Sounds pretty good, but nope, I really need to, you know, do some other equalization work on it to boost it or to attenuate in some areas to make it work. But these two are normally a really good start. So then you have those two files in the violet noise, in the blue noise, in the pink noise, in the white noise, in the gray noise, and in the brown noise. That is a really good file, you know, library to start with, so you have that in each one of those so that they are your go-to noise files that you can work on and, you know, improve upon or adjust them for situations. But most of the time, they will probably get the work done that you want. Then I've also made a file of white and pink noise. White noise is inherent in any circuitry without electricity. You add electricity and it sounds more like pink noise because of the electrons bouncing around inside there. So, but pink noise is a little bit harsh. So I went in there with my white and pink noise and I made a combination of, I've got the pink noise and then I took a white noise and I put it on top of it. And then I put enabled play overlaps on it so I could hear both those files on top of each other. And I added a little bit of white noise into it to where I was happy with it. It was evening out a little bit. So it wasn't quite so harsh because a lot of analog gear, the noise that it used to add in was a little bit harsher than you actually wanted. So the white noise can tame that a little bit. But you kind of have to experiment with it, and it's kind of an opinion thing. But normally, it's not a whole lot of white noise. And I've command bounced that together so that I have this file of white and pink noise. I've done that same work on it, and then I've made a file of that white and pink noise. And then I did it with equal loudness contour also. So this is my analog emulation file that I can go just to pink noise, or I can just add white noise, or I can add this combination, which is normally better. It sounds like electricity flowing through a circuit, but with the white noise, it's tamed a little bit. So it's not so harsh, so it's not so audible, so it doesn't add analog harshness to it. Does that make sense? You want analog warmth, not analog harshness. So that's kind of an experiment and an opinion of what sounds best. So you mixing it together, bouncing it together, and then working on it is going to be something you're going to have to work out about how which way sounds best to you. So that is, you know, the next file that you want in your library. The next one is, I've got this best mixes. Now, this one is basically, I've taken this file and I wanted the best ones that I can add. Down here, this is brown and gray. So this was the best lower end mixture that I could come up with because both these are lower, softer noises. So I've mixed these two together till the mixture of them sounds best. So that's a really nice soft file. And then I've mixed one that's violet and blue that are the two harshest noise, and I've mixed those together to where that sounds best, a mixture of them. And they will, you know, contradict each other and they're a little out of phase of each other. And so it kind of evens them out also. So I've made a mixture of that I was really happy with. Then I've made one that was a brown, gray, and blue. That brown and gray was really soft, but there's still this harshness to it because it doesn't have any harsh waves in it that it tames it, you know, like listening to, I don't know how to, you know, it's like listening to an MP3 that you've dithered, that the noise has tamed the harshness of it. So, but it's actually a white pink noise that's actually tamed it. So I've actually added a little bit of blue noise to this, and it's actually the softest sounding noise that it's just a beautiful sounding noise, this brown, gray, blue mixture. Then I did it with a brown, gray, white noise, and I added just a little bit more of this, a little bit harsher. That's going to have more of an analog sound with a really soft brown and gray mix to it that has more of a taming, out of control, harsh captures. So this is my mix of best noises. That they just sound really good. I've mixed them, I mixed them until they sounded really good and the best that they could sound, and then I made a separate file of them. And they were made from the equal loudness contour ones from these separate individual files up here. but you can do it of both if you want. And then, and if there's, with this library, if you look at this library will probably get done what you need done when working with noise. As you become a better and better audio engineer and start applying very specific aspects of noise to certain ranges in the spectrum, or to do really specific things, like I'm gonna say, well, you know, I really know that in this, on this file, that it needs some blue noise just in the upper end. So I'm, you know, high and low pass filtered, band pass filtered. So it's just right up in the upper end to really kind of, you know, even out and tame the harshness, because the equalizer is doing it a little bit differently. If I come down, the equalizer is not doing the same, but if I add a little bit of blue noise up in the upper, just the upper end, that it's working out of phase with the noise that is there and the harshness, and it sounds actually, it's got a reverse effect of actually taming it. Those are pretty master audio engineer applications that you will become more and more familiar with as you become a better and better audio engineer and really think about those type of concepts. But this library is the basic library you should have so that you've got a good library to start with. Like I said before, that normally your noise applications are very light and very delicate applications, but it can make a huge difference that you're using a violet noise or a gray noise. And sometimes it can be, you know, this gray noise a little bit with equal loudness contour work, just is a little bit different than the raw noise file that just pushes it into where it should be, because sometimes it just doesn't take much. Does that make sense? And, you know, you understand that the actual noise file has its own spectral characteristics that, you know, that you can change by mixing files together or affecting the spectrum with an equalizer. So those, that is a real basic library to start with. And I've found that most of the time, that library I can apply to just about anything I run into, unless I'm really trying to get into a specific spectral range with a really specific sound that's out front vocalist, you know, and it's like he really needs a little bit of pink and blue noise mixed together just right in the mid-range band pass to make his voice sound just perfect. That can be pretty complicated, but I've found most of the time that this library will get done what you want done. Unless you're really working on some really distorted sound that you really need harshness and a mess or something, like, you know, taking your trash too and mangling the distortion for some certain application, you know, and that can be different. But most of the time it's pretty delicate work, and this noise library will get done what you want done. And you just need to spend a little bit of time putting it together so that as you're applying noise and you're really working on your critical listening, that this basic file, you start to really hear the differences, how the different types of noises and mixtures affect different sounds, different instruments, different, you know, applications and different situations, so that you can start getting used to which ones are best for different type of applications and situations, which is going to take time because it's very opinionated, and somebody trying to tell you which one works best isn't always a good idea, because opinions can be very different and the situation can be very different. So it really is going to take time with you practicing applying them to different things to hear how they affect different things. So peace, hope, love. I certainly hope you enjoyed this video. I certainly hope you get your noise library together, and I will see you in the next video.